Yes, yes, it was very good. This is my second time in Poland, so like I know like there's really good people here, so. I think my advice is find style. Find style. You know, like nowadays it's b-boying to me, like my generation b-boying of like style elements, skill methods, and I mean even like growing up looking at Enemy Squad and The Family and Wedding B-Boys from like Europe, and you know, like it's so whack now, you know, like I think B-Boying now is just everybody, it's about who can copy the best and who can jump the highest and who can, it's not about style anymore, it's not about individuality anymore. And like the thing that like my generation is, everybody was so different and everybody had their own little style, you know, like, oh, there goes Little John, oh, there goes Kemel, oh, there goes Marlon, oh, there goes, you know, and like nowadays, it's just like, you don't know who's who, you know, and I think people are sacrificing style and swag and individuality for competition, and that's it, and that's it. Like, if you see BC1, it was a flipping competition, and it's embarrassing the fact that these b-boys are coming and traveling all over the world with 3 rounds. You know, some of those guys, it's just like I after 5 rounds I don't know what they have, you know. And you know, like a person like me, you know, especially for like my crew and my generation, like I'm not scared to say that, you know what I'm saying? Like, cause I don't do this for competition. I do this before competition was big, before there was a lot of money involved, you know? And so, like nowadays, I think people sacrifice style, individuality, creativity for competition, you know? And that's not what it's about. That's not what it's about. And if that's why you're breaking, if that's why you're doing this, to fly all over the place, then I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. I think that's so disrespectful, you know? When we first started, all we had was videos to teach us, you know? So I think a lot of b-boys, they have YouTube now, and YouTube is the world, like in your room, you know, and so it's like it's very easy, and it's very easy to bite, because nowadays is, it's not biting anymore, it's who does it better. You know, I've had people do stuff that I do and they tell me, yeah, but I do it better than you. But I'm like, but you weren't there creating it. You know what I'm saying? And so nowadays, biting, it's a very thin line, you know, because a lot of people don't take that much pride anymore, because back in the day, you couldn't bite, because everybody would be like, whoa, what are you doing? You're a biter. Like, they'll stop the battles, they'll call you a biter. Like, nowadays, it's okay. It's like, you know, and that goes again with competition. It goes again with people leaving behind like pride, like saying, I'm gonna make this up, this is my move, nobody's gonna take it. And it's all competition, man. It's all like, it comes down to who has the biggest name, you know? And some people are willing to bite all the way to the top. And the thing is, they do go all the way to the top. You know what I'm saying? Not original b-boys are at the top. If you see like the top b-boys flying all over the world, some of them like have nothing that's their own. Like they don't have anything that they created, but they're very good athletes, you know? So that's what it is. I think he's like one of us, you know what I'm saying? Like he's a creative guy and he's an idea man, and I mean that's what we are, you know what I'm saying? Like at the end of the day, like we're all like idea men, you know, and Havoc Horror Crew, like we're always all about ideas, and rounds and who's gonna outlast who and stuff like that. And I mean, that's the way I've always saw him ever since I first saw him. So I was like, I'm like, that's dope. Like, I'm like, I want to battle that guy. And I want to battle people that I think can beat me. You know, I don't want to battle people that I can smoke, you know, like that's doesn't do me any good, you know. Like, I want to dance, you know. I want to dance against the people that I respect, and I want to dance against the people that, like, while I still can, like, you know, I want to be able to challenge all those people that I think can beat me. So, very dope.
How do you feel before the battle?
Oh, I feel good, man. It's cold. It's so cold outside. I don't know. It's ridiculous. Yeah, I like Poland. Like, I like Poland. I like Russia. You know, like, it's very dope. I respect the B-boys that really put in work, and you can see it. You can see which B-boys are really true about their art, and you can see which B-boys just fake the funk, you know what I'm saying? And like for me, like, I respect any B-boy coming up, but like, for example, today El Nino had a workshop, 5 B-boys show up. Like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? Like, and it's ridiculous. I went to Russia, 7 people show up to a workshop. And it's just like, I'm like, you have to learn. Like, the thing is, you have to learn. And the way hip hop works is you teach each other. It's not a school, it's not a college thing. It's we teach each other generically. And so, like, it's really ridiculous when you see people going all crazy on the floor, don't know what they're doing, their technique's sorry, like it's just horrible. And then El Nino has a workshop the next day and nobody goes. I'm just like, what are you doing? Are you watching YouTube instead of going to a class? Because you can learn a lot from that. And like, if any advice that I have, you have to take advantage of the people that are in front of you. You know what I'm saying? So like, if I live in Russia, of course I wanna train with Top 9 and all the most and all those guys. You know, if I live in Poland, and you know what I'm saying, I wanna do that too. But then I also wanna take advantage of the people that are coming from outside too. Like, you have to do it. You have to respect it. It's a respect. Like B-boys have little respect for hip hop. They have little respect for hip hop, you know? And that goes again with all these new competition born B-boys that have no respect for hip hop. And I'm just like, are you serious? You know what I'm saying? And it's very disrespectful for me, because I know that hip hop has shown me the world. Hip hop has taught me education. You know, hip hop has taught me to express myself. It gave me my art, you know, my ability to speak. And so when people are so disrespectful to hip hop, I'm just like, man, it's so whack, you know what I'm saying? And that goes for anybody. Anybody that just exploits what we have and what we build just so they can do little bullshit, you know, like, you're fake, you know? That's straight up. I want to give a big shout out to everyone at Over the Top, you know what I'm saying? It's like, for me, like, to be here is pretty dope, you know what I'm saying? Like, especially to represent my crew, you know, a big shout out to Have a Coral crew. Like, that's my family, you know what I'm saying? That's the name that I've been repping, and that's what I do, you know what I'm saying? Big shout out to all the people coming up right, you know what I'm saying? All the people doing it right, all the poets, all the writers, and you know, big shout out to Floor Gangs, always, you know, always supporting me, you know what I'm saying? So that's it, you know, that's what's up.